Hi, Jonathan Chase, the hypnotist. I'm going to discuss hypnotic qualifications and organisations. If you want to sue, have a look around the site. You'll find a contact form, and we'll see each other in court. Qualifications, hypnosis qualifications. There is not in the United Kingdom, and I don't believe that there is in most of the states in the United States of America, there is not a recognized hypnosis qualification. I do know that the Medical Association and I believe the Dental Association as well run courses in hypnosis and give out a certificate that you've done it for your insurance, but there is certainly at this moment in time, as this film goes to the internet, goes to broadcast, there is no recognised qualification by anybody at the Home Office in this country whatsoever at all. Now, some of the courses may have a criteria that fits into what in this country we call the MVQ, which is the National Vocational Qualification. What that means is that that course or those courses fit the curriculum. They do the course in the way that the MVQ says they need to be. That's all they do. You know, the MVQ is not based on how good you are as a hypnotist in any way whatsoever at all. Most of the qualifications for clinical hypnotherapy have no clinical basis whatsoever at all, other than theoretical. In other words, you certainly don't learn them in hospitals, you don't have to go to university. One or two of them are running universities, but that's because, you know, I mean, I do some in universities myself. Not only do you get the kudos of doing them in the university, but the universities are usually cheaper to hire than hotels for training establishments if you don't have your own. So, but I'm not being derogatory for hypnosis qualifications, because what a hypnosis qualification actually means is that you've at least bothered to go out there and do something and get some sort of training. But nobody, you know, was ever hypnotized by a hypnotic qualification, unless of course you want to swing it in front of their face and tell them that their eyes are getting very tired. But certainly in the UK, hypnosis qualifications are what they are. They're a nice looking piece of paper on your wall. Organisations. There is no, as far as I'm aware, government recognised, legally recognised organisation of hypnosis in this country. In fact, the last time I looked on the internet, in the UK alone, there was 47 different organisations all claiming to be the ultimate organisation for hypnosis members, and you can take what you like from that. There's no Royal Society of Hypnotists for a start off, and even if people say that they're a member of this Royal Society or that Royal Society, there is no Royal Society of Hypnosis. And you know, Royal Societies aren't based on the acumen of the people involved. They're based on whether the Privy Council wants to give you the Royal signature or not. So don't always take qualifications as the be-all and end-all. If you are planning to do some hypnosis training, if you are planning to spend your bloody money on hypnosis training, don't worry about the qualification. You don't need that much of a qualification, if you need a qualification at all, to get insurance. Certainly not for remedial, for hypnotherapy, for clinical hypnotherapy. You do not need that much of a qualification, if you need a qualification at all, to get public liability insurance in this country whatsoever at all. You certainly don't need a qualification in stage hypnosis, although some sort of training would certainly do you the world of good. So don't base your investment on what sort of qualification they say they're offering. Base it on whether you're going to be a good hypnotist at the end of it and whether you're going to be confident enough to actually use the stuff when you get out there in the field. Now, I've recorded 20 of these little things. There might be a few more. There's certainly some videos knocking about of me hypnotizing people and doing that all sort of thing. There's a few more questions that you really should ask and you really should know the answers to before you go investing your money in hypnosis training, and I've tried to cover as many of those as possible. If you want these videos, if you want these opinions, and really you should get more than one opinion before you start making your mind up on anything, and this is probably an alternative opinion. It's certainly a maverick opinion. I like being maverick, I don't care. If you want to do that, you want to leave a comment, by all means leave a comment, let me know you're alive. Go along to learn-hypnosis.com, that's learn-hypnosis.com. Leave me your name, leave me your email address, and I'll be in touch with you and I'll send you these videos completely free, and we'll send you links to a lot more. I will not spam you, I promise.